So those are three facets. The fourth facet is psychological intensity. This is a characteristic of all the poems that we've read up until this point. They have this vigor of intellect, but it's definitely a key component to Donne's religious experience as expressed in his holy sonnets and other religious poems. There's this anxiety, a turmoil even, and part of that has to do with his conversion to Protestantism. You know, he started out as a Catholic. He grew up in a Catholic family, and living in Protestant England, he was at a disadvantage. Despite that disadvantage, he advanced, gained a patron. He then lost that patron by marrying his patron's niece. He secretively married Anne Moore, and then they ran off together. So he fell out of favor, and for 12 years, he was really destitute, living and trying to find employment, until King James I actually persuaded Donne to become Anglican, and Donne didn't take this lightly. Anglican was the Church of England, so Donne eventually became Protestant, and King James made him a priest in the Anglican Church, but this involved a huge amount of turmoil, psychic stress, which you can see in a lot of his poems. So let's look at Holy Sonnet 18, "Show me, dear Christ, thy spouse." Now, when he's referring to spouse, he's referring to the church. Show me which church is true. And this is a little insight into the turmoil of Donne's religious dilemma. Show me, dear Christ. See this trochee coming in? A sonnet, that's very unusual. It's unexpected, rather, I should say. For a sonnet, it's usually a beautiful lyrical meditation. You're easing in. But here, he's got this command at the beginning, and he's got the stress on the first word. Show me, dear Christ, thy spouse so bright and clear. What? Is it she which on the other shore goes richly painted? He asks, is it the Roman Catholic Church who is richly painted? That's who's figured here, gaudy, full of decorous trappings. Or, which robbed and tore, laments and mourns in Germany and here? Or is it the Protestant Church, which is robbed and tore? Notice how this decoration conceit, the conceit of clothing, is without. Robbed and tore, laments and mourns in Germany and in England. Sleeps she a thousand, then peeps up one year, thinking about the Protestant prejudice against Catholicism, which said, oh, well, the church was in darkness for 1,000 years, and then the Lord raised up a great light in Martin Luther and restored the church. Does she sleep 1,000 years and then suddenly come back? Is she self-truth and errors? The Catholic Church now. He's aiming criticism at both. The Catholic Church claims to be self-truth, confirms one thing in one papal encyclical, and then denies it in a later canon or council. Now new, now out war. He doesn't say old, he says out war. To go along with this conceit. Doth she, the church, and did she, and shall she evermore on one, on seven, or on no hill appear? Church of the Seven Hills, that's the Roman Catholic Church, Rome, surrounded by seven hills. One, perhaps Canterbury or Geneva. Or did she not on any hill appear? Dwells she with us? Or, like adventuring knights, first travel we to seek, and then make love? Is she among us, or must we go out and find her? Betray, kind husband, speaking of Christ. Betray means to reveal, not necessarily to turn over in a treacherous way. Show, reveal thy spouse to our sights, and let mine amorous soul court thy mild dove, who is most true and pleasing to thee then when she's embraced and open to most men. The relationship between Christ and his church is typified in many of St. Paul's epistles and in the book of Revelation, often described as a marriage between lovers. And Donne on the outside, how do I court thy spouse? How do I become the church? What church should I go to? This is part of the turmoil he's experiencing. Satire 3, from which this sonnet comes, it was an earlier poem written in Satire 3, is much more intense. So check that out as well. But this gives a little insight into Donne's dilemma. He did not take this conversion lightly. But the other kind of psychological intensity, it's not just seen in romantic argumentation are with this ecclesiastical dilemma, but also in the internal experience of devotion by which the soul is relating to God. And I think this one is very confessional.